It's old time hockey, the way you're supposed to play. You throw a little lumber if a guy gets in your way. You play like Gordie Howe or Eddie fucking Shore. We can't all be Gretzky, some user Bobby Orr's. Hey!
Ty just squirted water all over these guys behind him. That's when you need the Gatorade, about 9-1 with the syrup. That'll straighten those guys out.
Now, you've had...
Let him in! Let him into the box!
Whoa!
All right! Watch the lawsuit, Ty. Watch the lawsuit. Kevin Collins, he's broken up fights before, but not in the penalty box. I'm so happy that man fell in.
Oh, boy. The glass gave way, and that rather rotund Philadelphian went surprisingly to himself, I'm sure, into the penalty box. Ty's now coming out of the penalty box.
They're going to throw Ty out of the game, I think. And the fan's going to get 10 minutes anyway.
Well, they're trying to, they're going to need a forklift to get him back in the seats.
I'd give him the fork, all right, never mind the lift.
So, you went to the hockey game and then what happened?
Oh, hey, how do you enjoy the game, big fella? You thought that glass was protecting you, you bonehead.
We all knew it was going to happen sooner or later. Here's Ty Domi. If you watched hockey in the 90s, definitely one of the toughest guys going was Ty Domi. So tough, in fact, that in high school, when my friends and I could get our hands on alcohol, we would make a drink called the Ty Domi. It consisted of a glass of beer and shots of any alcohol that you could get your hands on, all in one glass. If you could down the whole thing in under 2 minutes without puking, you were considered a genuine tough guy and a man. If not, you were ridiculed and called a pussy for the rest of the night. But let's get back to where it all started for Ty Domi. He began his junior career with the Peterborough Petes of the Ontario Hockey League in 1986. Over the course of the next 3 years, he would play in 121 games, scoring 37 goals and getting 38 assists for 75 points. He wasn't the most prolific goal scorer, but that's not what led him to get drafted by the Toronto Maple Leafs, 27th overall in the second round of the 88 NHL entry draft. It was his 546 minutes in penalties during his career in the OHL that caught the attention of scouts. Ty Domi spent his first season in the pros split between the AHL's Newmarket Saints and the Toronto Maple Leafs of the NHL, playing in only 2 games for the Leafs, but amazingly racking up 42 minutes in penalties. During the offseason, he was traded to the Rangers, and in 1991 debuted there, scoring his first NHL goal and racking up 185 penalty minutes in just 28 games, solidifying his role as an NHL enforcer. During the 92-93 season, he was traded to the Winnipeg Jets, where he spent the next 2.5 seasons. In the 1993-94 campaign with the Jets, he racked up the most penalty minutes in the NHL with 347. Toronto, looking to add another enforcer to their roster after losing Wendell Clark, Domi was traded back to the Leafs, where he would play the next 11 seasons with Toronto, becoming an assistant captain in the process. Domi had a highlight career full of great hits, good fights, and he can even put the puck in the net a couple of times. All in total, he played in 1,020 career NHL games, scoring 104 goals and 141 assists for 245 points. But this is not what's going to get him remembered. It's his astonishing 3,515 minutes spent in the penalty box, third all-time just behind Dale Hunter and Dave Tiger Williams. Will Ty Domi ever make the Hall of Fame? It's unknown. I believe he should be a candidate just based on his penalty minutes alone, and the fact that no modern player will ever surpass that 3,000-minute plateau. But even though he played with the Leafs, Ty Domi was still one of my favorite players of all time, and probably one of the toughest guys ever to put on skates. So in closing, I'm going to leave you with the all-time heavyweight fights of Ty Domi versus Bob Probert, as narrated by Don Cherry.
And now, here we go with the heavyweight, folks. My good buddy, Ty Domi, and my other buddy, Bobby Probert, star of Rock'em Sock'em. Still don't understand why Bobby doesn't have those tie-downs. See what happens? The sweater gets tied up there. But both guys, nobody was hurt in this one either. Here's Ty losing that left-hander. Boy, I could never use a left hand. Look at the difference in size. And now here's a return match. Boy, in New York City, ESPN guy said there was more interest in this fight. It was like a heavyweight championship fight than anything that happened in New York last year. Boy, oh boy, are there two going. There's Ty with that left-hander again. Watch, he gets the helmet off. He's got to get that helmet off. He doesn't want to hurt his hand. Still going. Nobody was hurt here. Boy, the crowd was going nuts. If we go up in the crowd, I'm glad Ty didn't get that left-hander there. Two good guys going. Ty comes right back even in that. Watch, he's smiling. He's smiling right there. Nobody hurt here, folks. See, he's still smiling. Pretty gets a pretty good shot right here, though. Bang, that was a pretty good shot. It's all time.